Hi, my name is Justin Taylor. I'm a physician scientist and assistant professor at the Sylvester Comprehensive Cancer Center at the University of Miami Miller School of Medicine. And I'm delighted to share this author's take video on behalf of my co-authors and colleagues at Memorial Sloan Kettering Cancer Center, specifically Darren Feldman and Omar Abdelwahab. And I'll be telling you today about our project on germ cell tumors and associated hematologic malignancies that evolve from a common shared precursor. As background, leukemias arising in patients with primary mediastinal germ cell tumors has been recognized to be a strong association and is a major problem because of the increased mortality among these patients. About 30 years ago, researchers at Memorial Sloan Kettering Cancer Center observed that leukemias arising in patients with mediastinal germ cell tumors shared an isochromosome 12p, which is a karyotypic abnormality seen commonly in germ cell tumors, but never observed in leukemias arising outside of this setting. However, questions regarding the hematologic malignancies arising in these patients remained, first, the basis of the shared clonal origin. Is it that there's a shared precursor for both the germ cell tumor and the heme malignancy? Or does the heme malignancy arise from aberrant hematopoietic transdifferentiation from these cells within an established germ cell tumor? Furthermore, the comprehensive genetic features of leukemias and hematologic malignancies arising in patients with germ cell tumors had not been fully described. So we set out to collect paired germ cell tumor and hematologic malignancies from patients, both locally at MSKCC through the clinics and a medical donation program, or internationally and nationally through Make an Impact program, which provides genetic sequencing at no cost to qualifying patients with rare cancers such as this. We collected a cohort of 15 patients that had germ cell tumor and a subsequent hematologic malignancy, and we had 12 patients where we had the germ cell tumor, hematologic malignancy, and matched germline DNA, and performed both the targeted sequencing with MSK impact panel as well as whole exome sequencing, and performed mutational analysis and copy number analysis to infer clonality and evolution of these two diseases. And I'll show you here an example in a patient with germ cell tumor and subsequent hematologic malignancy, where we observed shared somatic mutations in both tumors. This patient had an I12P, which was additionally shared. Another patient, as an example, this patient had four malignancies: the primary mediastinal germ cell tumor, followed by three different myeloid hematologic malignancies. However, this patient did not have I12P, thus cytogenetics alone would not probably have identified the shared clonality here, but we did find other copy number abnormalities were shared, as well as a shared set of somatic mutations across all four tumors. And then we're able to map a shared origin of the histiocytosis and CMML, as well as the AML, through unique genetic alterations between each disease. And we come up with a phylogenetic tree such as this, where we have the branches representing each of the malignancies, and we can link them by the shared copy number alterations or mutations and infer that there is a precursor clone that had to have given rise to the individual diseases, germ cell tumor, as well as separately these other malignancies. And in every patient that we did this analysis, we observed the same thing, where a shared ancestral clone bearing mutations shared by all the tumors then gave rise to branching evolution of these different tumor types, the germ cell tumor distinct from the hematologic malignancy. And when we look across these samples, our cohort is shown in the middle, and we compared them to a cohort of mediastinal germ cell tumors that from patients that did not develop secondary hematologic malignancies, as well as patients with de novo acute myeloid leukemia who had not had any prior cancer. And we clearly note that in addition to I12P, which is only shared between hematologic malignancies arising from patients with germ cell tumor, as well as mediastinal germ cell tumors without hematologic malignancies, and they are not seen in any de novo AML patients. But also, our cohort was enriched for RAS pathway mutations and P53 mutations, again, more similar to mediastinal germ cell tumors and very different than the types of mutations seen in de novo AML, such as FLT3, NPM1, or DNMT3A, which were not observed in our cohort. In summary, I encourage you to read the paper for all the details, but we propose a model where a shared common precursor gives rise to both the mediastinal germ cell tumor and the hematologic malignancy, and that these tumors share common alterations in RAS and P53. We hope that this work will lead to development of better treatments for these patients and potentially the earlier recognition of these patients to allow for potential early interventions. Thank you.